What's up, guys? Corey here. I just got through stretching some carpet here. Now I'm gonna do, it looks like three or four rooms. I don't know, I think there's three there and one here. Anyway, this is fancy carpet. You don't see this every day. So I'm gonna start with the prettiest room first. And it's subject to opinion whether or not you think it's pretty, but it's damn sure rare. So here we go. Harvest Gold. This carpet is, I was born in 73, so this carpet is probably about that same age. And it's got a lot of sun fade to it. There's just a lot going on in here. And if there was ever an animal peeing, you couldn't prove it. So that's what's unique about this. And I'm on a clean carpet that's, God, this is, I just can't imagine cleaning carpets about my same age. That's be interesting. If they made it better back then, I would certainly think so. And everything else is not quite as fancy. This is where I stretched it out here. Generally, when you stretch, a good cleaning is in order because it was bunched up here. And now you pad through it, clean it all off, and it looks good again. A little dot right there. So yeah, four rooms. Got this guy here. It's all moderately soiled, and this is a slight upgrade. Even though it's, you know, 100 years old, it's still a little bit better fiber than what you'll run into in the newer houses. And like I said, you know, you can't necessarily, just because a house is expensive, assume that the carpet is of high quality, because most people will cut corners in newer homes when it comes to putting in the flooring. When I built my house, I didn't build a high-end home at all, but when I built it, I was just about done spending money when it came time to talk about flooring. Anyway, I'm gonna start in the beautiful, beautiful Harvest Gold room first. Have all the fun I can have, and then come do these three rooms and hall. No stairs, look at that. And this tile and grout is in really big need of cleaning, but I never mentioned it. I've got more than I can do right now, so I never mentioned this. All right, let's start right here. I guess I'll set up the camera and spray. That's about right. This one I'm using the vlogging camera because I'm going to be recording, you know, while I clean. And if I use the phone for that, every time the phone rings, it gets cut off. So I haven't got to do it. All right. Anybody wants me to make a specific video about this sprayer, there's a certain way you've got to modify it to make it last. I may have put it in other videos. I believe I did, it's just not in the title. But this sprayer is $29 usually, and you can always get it for $19 if you use the 20% off or whatever. They run coupons on it all the time at Harbor Freight for $19.99. So you just have to adjust the straps, modify them a little bit, and then know how to properly oil it right, and this one's about a year and a half old. And generally, a good thing to do is buy two of them, because it's always one little thing that'll break. And if you just, if you have two of them, you switch to the new one and start taking parts off the old one. I keep a spare one in the vehicle in case something happens to this one. Because I don't enjoy using the public sprayer. After you use this one, the public sprayer is really, really slow. I like the way this is the cone shaped nozzle on this one, and it puts out a really fine mist. So you want to mist the carpet kind of slowly like this, that way you get enough on it to transfer the soil.
And this, again, this one is simple green and hydrogen peroxide only. That's the only thing I'm using in my sprayer right now. I've actually been considering maybe adding a step to carpets that are extremely soiled and maybe make them go a little faster. What I was considering doing is using the Oreck with a light brush to agitate the heavy traffic areas. See if I like to turn out the outcome is better that way. Thinking I probably would. Trouble is, when you get used to doing one thing one way, you go to change, and it's difficult to remember. See, it takes 21 days to form a habit, so I'm going to start doing that. I guess I need to start pretty soon. All right. Nobody take that. Remember in the very beginning when I started this business, I had all these buddies I'd meet down at the carpet supply place. I knew who all was in Austin, who was in business, who my competition was. Now, since I switched to this method, I never see carpet people but for online because I don't shop where they do anymore. I can pick up everything I need on the drive over. Between you get Simple Green at Walmart, Home Depot, or anywhere. And luckily, the Sally Beauty Supply I go to is directly across the street from Home Depot, so it's a two-stop process. Thank you. up really well. I don't believe at this angle you can enjoy it quite enough. I don't even know. As I can see it a little brighter in the little monitor on my wrist than I can through the camera itself. There's not a light in here either. All right, I'm gonna set it up here and watch the rest of it here. Got here and started, I cranked the AC down to 60. Thank goodness. Thank you. the grooming portion. Part that takes all the special skill. Hey guys, I just did a bunch of recording a while ago. I looked down to turn off the camera and the light was blue, which indicated I wasn't recording, so I don't know what I got. And I'm not gonna go back and look. So we can go take a look at the yellow Harvest Gold carpet I just finished. And then I'll catch you up in a little bit. But I went around and looked at all the intercom systems in the house and everything. The fan should actually be placed in the other part of the room blowing out the door, but I don't want to forget my fan, so I put it right there. I take everything that I don't want to forget and I put it on the floor, preferably on the way out the door, so I don't forget it. Even though it's making all that racket, I could still walk off and leave it. All right, I'm going to clean these two rooms here, this room and this room. And I'm expecting this to turn out really, really well. And there's naturally nothing tall to put the camera up on. No luck there. All right, so.
This carpet here, I am not going to groom it. It looks pretty cool not being groomed. Looking all fluffy just like it ought to. When I put together my prices, they're based on basically not vacuuming, because the way I see it is, well, let me tell you a little more. Basically, I feel like, now this is the way I prefer a house to be. I on the website, I ask people to please pre-vacuum before I arrive. I figure that if I don't vacuum, I can save the client a little money. And if you don't vacuum your own carpet, why do you want it clean? You know, I don't understand. Now, if I dig up a bunch of hair when I'm cleaning, I'll vacuum that up because you want it to look presentable. But, you know, my whole thing is if I can save you a little money by you doing a little bit yourself by vacuuming, then I don't need to charge so much. I guess at some point, if that ever becomes an issue, I'll just raise prices and vacuum whether I need to or not. But I've been going this way for a really long time and it's been working.
Yeah, I said a while ago I wasn't going to groom. I think this room needs it, definitely. So I'm probably going to groom them both. I'm going to do that right now, and then probably pick up the video over here. All right, last room here. Did the hallway to right here. Haven't groomed the hallway yet. I did groom these two rooms. I'm going to go back in there. Everything turned out great. So, I'm going to clean this one. It will be done. Done. So, I'm going to put the camera, I guess, here. Do over here first.
Getting close. All right, now to finish out the video. Apologize for all that I missed earlier somehow. Everything turned out good here. Technically, I saved the carpet, but, you know, not really. There's nobody that's going to buy this house that's not going to tear this carpet out the absolute first thing when they buy it. And then all the countertops, and then all the cabinets, and a few walls, and just completely redo the whole place to whatever standards they're, what do you call those guys, remodelers or whatever, or the people that go around, home decorating people that, like the Chip and Joanna type that, you know, come in and redo the whole place. Well, this is a prime candidate for all of that, so that's what's going to happen here. And I would bet even this tile and everything's going. Maybe they'll keep this room here because it's beautiful harvest gold. I'll be the only person around with it. All right, guys. Appreciate you watching the video. I'm off to do a cleaning, a little teeny tiny bathroom cleaning for a pest control company that I go out whenever their employees, you know, attract mud or something in. I go out for them and I clean it up. So I got that, and then there's something later in the day beyond that. I don't remember what that is. Take a look later. All right, guys, thanks for watching. God bless.